Yeah, yeah, we're on Facebook Live. You can tell your people to go to the Club Hip Hop page and they can see everything we got. What's up, y'all? This is Hip Hop Radio behind the scenes. We are getting ready to throw down, and this is our pre-show. So y'all know how we do. Let me get everything ready. Test, test, 1, 2. All right, oh, that sounds good. All right, let me get my countdown. Three. Two, one.
Tuned in to Above All Eyes Show, giving the scoop and the latest on how the story goes. Broadcasting from Vegas, in case you didn't know. Worldwide Great Commission, that's the gospel. Discussing topics and standards, righteous living. Bumping them bangers and interviewing different Christians. Who's hot, who's not, does it really matter? It's his hop, non-stop, focus on the ladder. Stay tuned to the dial and turn that volume up. This faith radio, Jesus is who we lifting up. So in your ears, we gon' be here for a minute. It's my bro, D-Ro, he about to come with it.
All right, you know what's going down, you know what's up when you hear that music and you see the stream. This is Hip Hop Radio, and I want to thank you once again for tuning in and spending time with us. Tonight is going down, we got kinfolk in the house all the way from Cali, and this is our pre-show, and I got some special guests in studio with me today. But before we get into that, I want to remind you to download the Hip Hop Radio app. It's Hip Hop Radio in your app store, HISHOP. Download it and it will keep you in the mind of Christ 24/7 as you bump that holy hip hop. And also go to our website, hiphopnation.com. We are streaming there 24/7. You can get information, sign up with our email address. You get all of our information there, and you'll just stay plugged in with what we got going. So tonight, you know, I'm solo as far as Super J. She's not in studio with me today, but I'm gonna introduce another co-host today, and this is my boy Rifika. Rifika, what's up, man? Say what's happening to the people.
Hey, what's up, y'all? Glory go to God and unto me. Happy to be here on Hip Hop Radio for the first time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Now, look, break down your name, Rifika. You know, you got to do your breakdown.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, Rifika is an acronym. It stands for Righteous in Faith, Increase Abundantly. And really, all Christians are Rifika because all Christians should be righteous in faith, increasing abundantly. It's not about me.
Amen. Amen. That's right. And so today we have, as you were saying, your mentor in studio with us. So yeah. I'm going to give you the privilege to give him a great introduction and to bring him in.
Okay, so. Okay. All right, well, Educator, man, he been doing Christian hip-hop. He like a holy hip-hop founder or something like that. He been doing Christian hip-hop in the Houston area since, man, like, what, 25 years now? 27 years now.
Come on,
sure,
now,
I changed.
Amen. Come
yeah,
on.
Yeah, holy hip-hop vet, you know what I'm saying? Really, everybody, when they get into Christian hip-hop, they got to go through Educator. I remember when I first started, Mike D brought me to Educator, and he was trying to make sure that I really wanted to do this and I was going to be real about it. And plenty of other Christian hip-hop artists in Houston got to do the same thing. You know, you got to get approval from Educator first before you can start. No.
Oh, wow. Like that, huh? Well, man, I'm going to submit. Where do I submit my resume, my brother? What are you, know what I mean? My credentials, man.
No, man. You know what, man? God is so great, man. Just being a willing vessel, man. Being Amen. Available. You know, the Amen. Best the best ability is availability.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So,
yes.
You know, man, God gave me a desire to do something. And man, I just went forward, man. And then going forward, God put you in position to help mentor people, encourage.
Amen.
To, you know, be available to the people when they seeking an alternative.
Amen.
And so, I've been doing it a long time, but, you know, I can't take the credit. It's all God, man.
Amen.
And because it's him, you know, God commission us to make disciples.
Yeah.
Prepare others. And, you know, when you're doing something and somebody come into your lane and they not doing it correctly because they don't know how to do it, that's a problem if you allow them just to go through the motion. So you want to teach them the right way to do it. You know, in Titus chapter 2, it tells about the old men teaching the young men.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
And the old women teaching the young women. And so that's what it's all about, man.
And
so,
man, you really struck a chord because our ministry, we believe in discipleship. But what I've found with my ministry, not too many people want to be discipled, man. A lot of people, they don't want to be told what to do. They want to go out and do it their way or whatever. They kind of want to come and get the benefits of the ministry and then run off and do their own thing with it now that they got a little shine, you know what I'm saying?
You know,
and sometimes God will weed those people out, yeah, you know.
But you know what the thing is, a lot of times, you know, when people come in, they're coming in with a talent mindset.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
On what I know how to do.
Mm-hmm.
But you can't rap about Jesus or sing about Jesus if you don't know about him.
If you don't know him personally.
If you don't know him personally.
Yeah.
So anybody can try to come with talent. And, you know, I know some cats in San Antonio, Texas called me up and was like, hey, man, you know, man, my aunt told us about you, man, or whatever. And they was like, man, we can do this gospel too. I said, man, this is everyday life. You can't do secular and come do gospel. You can't do this.
Come on.
You know, because this is not a hobby. This is not an entertainment thing. This is not a, it is a form of entertainment because, you know, it's music and stuff like that. But this is not something that you can just jump in and jump out. We need to be practicing for excellence. You know, you're not going to be, you don't have to be perfect, but you can't be set up where you can cause other people to stumble, you know what I'm saying? And so you can't pat a cake and jump on this side and say, oh, I'm gonna do this and then I'm gonna do that, because now you're confusing the people.
Yeah exactly.
They don't know, are you about Jesus or not? Are you saved or you not?
Are you
trying to do a 180 or 360? Which one is
exactly
it,
you know? And that's what I try to tell people, you know. It's not a, you know, if I put you up there and you're in public ministry,
yes,
then tomorrow you out getting high and all that. I mean, you're in public, you profess publicly you about this life with Jesus, but now you're gonna cause people to stumble and it's funny. It just seems like this generation, they just don't get that.
Yeah, but
they
don't
get that.
You know, a lot of it with the people, we get so caught up as the church.
Uh-huh.
We get so caught up on when somebody that's in the world come and profess Jesus, that like that's a trophy.
Uh-huh.
You know, meaning, you know, I've been doing this walk with Jesus over 27 years now, right?
Uh-huh.
But people like, oh man, educated, cool, whatever, boom. But let a secular artist just do a song
about Christianity,
and we want to play it on every radio station, everything. And oh man, look, now this is a representation of that.
Bam.
And so what you have is nobody sitting underneath anyone, because they just going, as soon as they come in and say, man, I want to give my life to God and I know I need to make a change or whatever, we want to put them on them and give them a microphone.
Amen.
Instead of allowing them to go through the process. You can't skip steps.
Amen.
And so we make them go.
Come on.
We push them all the way forward. As soon as you just got saved, you gonna rap today for Jesus. So now you got a person who don't know how to appreciate the moment that God has allowed them to be in or presented to them. So now they're just going off of what they know how to do. But God got to allow us to be broken down to build us back up how he want us to be.
See, there's a difference between being talented and being anointed. You know what I mean? You
got to
get that anointing in your life, and you got to get that foundation.
Yes.
Because another thing I tell people is, once you step up to this, you're a target. You got a big target on your back, and Satan is going to try to, he's going to try to come through your job. If he can't get you in your job, he's going to come through your family, your marriage, your finances, you know what I mean?
Right.
A lot of people, they try to step up, then all of a sudden all these problems happen.
Right.
And they don't know why they can't do what they want to do for the Lord. I'm like, hey, this is warfare. Mm-hmm. Do you know how to war on the floor? You know, this ain't no game. And people, they, you know, they want to say, oh, he's the most talented artist, so we're going to follow him. Like, wait a minute. You know, look at his walk. Look at his fruit. Look at his spirit. You know what I'm saying?
Is he coming to the side to get CD sales?
Amen. Amen.
I mean, come on. I mean, that's not calling about out, but you have to have a servant's heart when you do ministry, when you do music on the gospel, because it's about establishing the relationship. It's about building. It's about serving others. And yes. So if your mindset is not that, as soon as a few people don't buy your CD, now you like, man, I'm maybe I made the wrong decision.
I know.
Because you have a heart issue. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because, yeah, you did make the wrong decision because you made it out of the wrong mindset.
Yeah. Because of what you wanted to do.
Because of what you wanted to do. But God didn't tell you to do that.
All right. Well, tonight, we have a show tonight. We want to promote it. Club Hiss Hop. Doors open 6 o'clock. 3949 East Patrick Lane is the spot. So come on out tonight. Club Hiss Hop. Ken Folk is in the house. Rain is going to do a little something. And Educator, my man here, he's going to give us a track tonight as well. And also, I put the number right here on the station. If you want to call in and pray, say a prayer for our people in our nation, Houston and in Florida. You know, we're going through a lot right now. We want to make that available to you. So just go ahead and call that number and we will pray with you. We're going to say a prayer before we end the interview. Anyway, so right now, Educator, man, I can tell you're a deep brother. You got some roots that go deep down. And we're going to get into some of your music. The track I have queued up is called No Freedom. So tell us a little bit about this song before we play it.
Okay, so, you know, our country been in hurt mode, right?
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Hatred and backbiting and fighting and turmoil. And then it's just the attempt of the enemy to make us be in that mode of hate, to separate.
Yeah.
And so he wants us to have no freedom. So the idea of this song is just to encourage the people that, hey, it's a trick. Don't fall for it. You know, God wants us to operate in love, to operate in the freedoms that God has bestowed upon us.
Amen.
So that's what it's all about.
So don't fall for the hate.
Yeah, don't fall for it.
Amen. I love it. All right, y'all. This is Educator right here live on Hiss Hop Radio.
Distractions all around, make it hard for us to rebound. no freedom. No freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom. We need to really wake up, cause it ain't about race or none of this stuff. If you wanna see change, then be changed. Say enough is enough. Stop fighting one another. Please, my sisters and my brothers. The devil try to separate. He want us all to dwell in hate. No freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom. No freedom, no freedom. No freedom, no freedom.
All right, man. That went out pretty quick. Said, no freedom, no freedom.
Yeah.
That is it. Okay. Man, I'm feeling that. I'm feeling that, man. You know, you got like a New York kind of a... Did anybody ever said that to you?
Yeah, I get some of that sometimes.
Yeah,
it seems... I'm down south, though, but...
Yeah, but it, he's got like a New York type of swag to it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Okay. All right, well, we have another song in the queue. And it's called Oasis, am I right?
Yeah.
All right, tell us about this song.
Okay, so this song, Oasis, it's that place where you are in Christ, man, where you free, where it's your sanctuary, where, you know, it's your whole moment of understanding that, you know, if it had not been for God being on your side, man, you know, you wouldn't be able to live these freedoms right now. And then with Oasis, I'm telling you that the freedom is only in Christ.
Amen.
So, you know, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty, there is freedom. So because of that, man, it's nothing that we can't do. You know, Philippians 4 and 13 said we can do all things. Say, I can do all things through Christ.
Who strengthens us, yeah.
You know, so because of that, bro, you know, it's like I'm free. So I'm going to walk in freedom. I'm going to do everything I have to do to uplift Jesus unapologetically. You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
Unashamed. I'm going to be unashamed forever. Because,
amen,
you know, for him I stand, man. And, you know, it's not about how perfect I am. But when he called on me, am I going to stand for him?
Amen.
And be bold.
Yeah.
If, when I can't make no CD sales, when I can't donate to nobody, when I can't do nothing else, am I still going to be available for Jesus to have a heart for his people? And that's what Oasis is standing for.
Amen. Amen. That's dope. That's dope. Now, real briefly, it doesn't have to be your whole testimony.
Yeah.
But tell us real quick, when did you decide to surrender everything to Christ, man? And, you know, when did you come? Because sometimes, even though you're a Christian, it takes a while to just submit to him as your Lord. You know what I mean? You know, submitting your thoughts, your attitudes, your actions and all that. What was it for you that brought you to your knees?
Okay, so we went to church, you know, these CME. Christmas, uh-huh. Mother Day, and Easter.
Oh, gotcha.
You know what I'm
saying?
Yeah. So we probably went to church for Easter.
Uh-huh.
So two of those days was already out of there.
Uh-huh.
So we really didn't have a foundation going to church. And so, but I knew it was a higher power, man.
Yeah.
And we grew up in poverty, me and my little brother. And not having much. Our dad wasn't there. Different circumstances caused that. But my mom was on drugs and stuff like that. And I was a straight A student. But real brief, man, at 13 I wanted to commit suicide.
Oh, wow.
And so, because I wanted to get out of the poverty, out of the mindset. My dad not there. I was like, man, there gotta be more to this. And so in the midst of me trying to do the suicide thing, this wind hit me. And I just sat down and started laughing. But that wind, that presence was God.
Wow.
And, man. And once that happened, man, I said, you know what? There's got to be more. So I went to church. I got baptized. And once that happened, man, you know, I just gave God my life and said, God, if I don't have nothing, I'd rather have you. And I'm going to put you first. And when I did that, I said, God, you got to give me something to do, though. And so I was already rapping.
And he said, "You rap, don't you?"
Amen. Come on.
And so,
yeah.
And so I was like, okay.
That's how it happened, yeah.
So then I had to come up with a name, and I was like, "God, you know, what's going to be the name?"
Uh-huh.
And so I heard his voice say, "What you do?" I was like, "Educate."
Educate, yeah.
So, you know, I have an acronym to educate, and it's Everyday Understanding Christ and Teaching Others Righteousness.
Oh, I love it.
And so he gave me that, man, and I just kept running. And so now it's been 27 years later. About to release my 17th album, man. And I bless God for being able to be an encouragement to my brothers, my sisters, to whomever, man, that whatever you do for Christ, that's what's going to stand, that's what's going to last. And when Amen. He planted inside of you, he going to always make provisions for the vision.
Amen.
Amen.
Always. And so, yeah, that's my testimony, and I'm sticking to it. And I bless God for just mercy and grace, man. Not his perfection, not mine.
Amen.
Because when I'm weak, he is made strong, man. And without him, I'm nothing. But with him, I'm everything. And so by that, man, I bless God. And that's why we're here right now, to have an opportunity to speak on him.
Amen.
That is his Amen. Radio.
Yeah, exactly.
His house.
Yes, you know yes. What I'm saying? His club.
His club.
In the middle of Las Vegas.
So that's huge, man. You know, when you say it's his.
Amen. I feel you. Amen.
We can really preach that right there real
come
fast.
Come on.
but it's his. And because it's his, the greater is he that's in me than
he who's in the world.
You see what I'm saying? So we his.
Come on.
So we do this for him. He gonna make it shine. He gonna make it do what it do. He say if I be lifted up, if he be lifted up, he draw all men. But so when you put him first, it has no choice to work. Even in Las Vegas.
Look, he's preaching my testimony. Hey, I've been grinding for 5 years, man. And brother, trust me, it's been a battle. It's been a battle. All right, now let's go ahead and get into your next track. Oasis, y'all. This is Educator live on His Hot Radio. And then after this, we're going to take phone calls. If you want to call in, we're going to pray for our nation. We definitely need it. And please come on out to the show tonight. Doors open at 6. Show starts around 7, 7:30-ish. Hit us up.
Counting on my steps, can't waste my breath, ain't that much time left. Yeah, that's why I'm gon' make it count, by sharing the good news every time you hear my mouth. I speak the whole truth, so help me God. When I was younger, wanted to see proof, so I said, help me God. Sound like a reoccurring virus, so caught up in the feeling, scared to let go, nervous. Used to live bitter, but now I live better, because of love of the maker, Alpha and Omega. Yeah, I found that Oasis on the right path, because of our faces. Now I'm living free now, into my casino. Vision take over, press prayer is equal freedom. Yeah, singing we should overcome every obstacle in our way, because of the son of Oasis. Inside of me, I say living life free, abundantly. Greater is he inside of me. Now I got a new talk, now I'm on a new walk. I'm dying, quit on, you can call me new chalk. I'm a hopscotch away from being on top. When haters leave a big, don't make me soar, none stop. Rise to the top, what up, run higher again. Jesus is the cream of the crop, we must follow him. Yeah, I call that
off all faces. Now I'm living free now, in the mind and see now. Vision take over plus purpose equal freedom. Yeah, singing we should overcome every obstacle in our way by way of the sun oasis.
Alright, y'all, that was our boy Educator with the song Oasis, Finally I'm Free. I can remember when Christ set me free, man. I can remember when I first got saved, you know what I mean? I felt like something was just pouring over me, and I felt clean, you know what I mean? Like something was lifted off of my life, man, and it's a powerful thing. So tonight, we are broadcasting from the Hip Hop Headquarters, Club His Hop, the only Christian hip hop nightclub in Las Vegas. And tonight we're about to turn it up. We shine a light that is brighter than any light on the strip, because it is the light of Christ that we're shining. And we're letting people know that we love them, God loves them. And living for God, you don't have to be bored. It doesn't have to be boring. You know what I'm saying? Right. You can turn up and do it right. The only thing that God takes out of your life is the things that will destroy you. But the things that are good, he makes even better. You know what I'm saying? He's not some cosmic killjoy. You know what I mean? Trying to be like, oh, y'all can't handle fun now since you saved. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So we just trying to let people know that. And that's why we are here in Vegas doing what we do. Like I said, 3945 East Patrick Lane is the location. Come on out if you're in Vegas. You got time before the show. And right now, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and pray for the people that we know, the people that we love. And both of you are from Houston, am I correct?
Right. Yeah.
And I know you guys have family members and friends out there. Are your people okay, first of all?
Yeah. Everybody's okay. Good.
Everybody's good?
Yeah, all my people.
Your people good?
Yeah.
Okay. I got some people in Florida, some friends. I don't know of any family members, but some of them fled and some stayed. And I'm kind of nervous about the ones who stayed, you know, but they feel pretty confident in staying. You know, one of them is my sister, Stephanie. You know, she actually helps me manage the show, the radio show. So I just want to agree in prayer and allow God to have his way. So Heavenly Father, we just come before you. We lift up our nation before you. And God, we know in your word that things have to come to pass. You know, your word will come to pass. And we know, and I truly believe that we are living in the last days. But even so, Father God, we pray for the safety of our family members and our loved ones, those who are in Florida right now, where this hurricane is about to touch down. We pray, God, that you just keep them safe. Let the loss of life be none or minimal, at least, Father God. And I pray, Father, that this will draw people closer to you. What's happening? Let this be a wake-up call to many people in our world. You know, earthquakes and hurricanes and wildfires and things that are just happening that are happening at a rapid rate. But God, we will not live in fear. And Father God, we will trust you, Lord. Even in the midst of the storm, we will praise you. And that's what we're going to do tonight. We're going to dedicate tonight to praise you, Father. So we thank you and we bless you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. And my brother said,
amen.
Amen. All right, all right. Well, with that, we got to go ahead and get ready for the show. But before we do that, Educator, can you hit me with that drop for His High Radio?
Yo, it's Educator. I'm Gospel in the building. We on the His Hop Radio, with His Hop
is the movement.
Amen, amen. Let's do that one more time. One more time.
Educator, I am Gospel in the building. His Hop Radio. Well, His Hop is the movement. One.
All right, all right. Keep it locked to His Hop Radio, y'all. We're about to jump it off another Club His Hop. Until we meet again, remember, it's not about us. It's all about the Christ. It's in us, y'all. Peace.
Amen. Amen.